Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.2, Problem 6. This is Section 7.2, Problem number 6. It says, look up the value for z in the chart and draw the graph and shade in the appropriate region. And the value we want to look up for this problem is 2.01. So, there's a four-step process to look up any value in the chart. Step 1, write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. This one already has two places after the decimal, so there's no work to do for step 1. But sometimes you have to fill in a few zeros or just round the number off. But in this case, we're all set to go to step number 2, which is split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. The rightmost digit is the 1, so we'll split this number into 2.0 and 1. That's step 2. I've split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit, which was the 1. Step 3, put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you've pulled off. So the 1 gets written as a 0.01. Now step 4, go to the chart and the digits from the left will tell you what row of the chart to look in, and the digit from the right with a 0.0 in front will tell you what column of the chart to look in. And you have to pay attention to be on the correct page of the chart. There's a positive page and a negative page. 2.01 is positive, so of course we want to be on the positive page of the chart. So if we go to the 2.0 row and the 0.1 column, the very first column 0.0, so you don't want to be in the first column, you want to be over into the second column. And you see where the 2.0 row and the 0.1 column intersect. They intersect at 0.9778. So that's our answer, but it's important to understand what that answer means. So what that means is we've taken the bell curve, and you can write it so that it has some numbers underneath. Underneath the very center, we'll put a 0. On the far right side, we'll put a 3. On the far left, we'll put a negative 3. And then we, by eye, split up positive 1, positive 2, positive 3 on the right, and then on the left, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. And these numbers represent how many standard deviations you are away from the average value. 0 being 0 standard deviations away from the average, because the average is in the center. 3 standard deviations larger than the average. Negative 3 standard deviations less than the average value. So what we looked up, 2.01, is just the tiniest bit past the 2. So 2.01, that's what we looked up. Now the number from the chart, 9778, is the probability of being to the left or less than that value. So I'll shade that area in on my bell curve. And I'll label it as 0.9778. So there's approximately a 97.75% probability of being in that shaded region of the bell curve.